Ronnie is upset that JD fell off the face of the earth. That's Ronnie's quote. He says, you know, JD has not reached out to Ronnie except a few times since March. Very few times.
I was there way before John. Let's put it that way.
And John became his best friend.
I was trying to get him to be more out there with people. Like, you know, when we used to do the block party shows, you know, I would get him out there. I'd make him, you know, take pictures with people, sign autographs. You know, he would meet girls, you know, and he finally would have a life and a lot of fun. I get where he's coming from. You know,
where is he coming from?
Well, I'm the old guy now. You know, it's like, you know, kind of like his father. So, you know, he don't want to hang out with his father anymore. You know, I get it.
Listen, I'm not a great friend. I don't reach out to people a whole lot. Has nothing to do with necessarily you. I'll say you're a lot more funner to hang out with than John. You're definitely a party. I like hanging out with you.
All right, JD, I'm going to put you to the test right now. And I hate to put you on the spot, but this is the way I roll.
Okay.
Jon Hein and Ronnie are living during the Nazi Holocaust in Germany. Let's call this movie Dopey's Choice. And you have to make a choice. One of them has to go into the gas chamber because the Nazis say to you, look, you got two friends, we're going to torture you. You can let one live, you can let one die. So that means you've got to make the ultimate decision.
You've got to choose.
God.
Just give me one name. Give me a name.
I would send John to the gas chamber and Ronnie to live.
Wow. All right.
So he doesn't call you Ronnie. He will save your life. No.
Yeah, but to save my life.
Why Ronnie over Jon Hein?
I don't know. There's really no reasoning. I'm just fucking, I just want this to be over. I want this conversation to be over because I don't like it.
Let's hear from Jon Hein. John, how do you feel now that you've been sent to the gas chamber by JD?
It hurts. I'm genuinely surprised. And this one stings, Howard. It really stings. You know, I try to be a good friend to both of these guys. I reach out. I do my best. I know I'm not as exciting as Ronnie. And it's
why are you dragging me into it? Why did
you drag me into it? You started off with, oh, I was here before John.
Yeah, I was.
And no, you weren't.
I was. I was the one who got him out there, man. You didn't do that.
I'm not. Hey, we have a different kind of friendship. I'm not saying
that. You weren't friends with him then.
If you want to see how hard it is, Robin, choose one of these two guys. One lives, one dies.
I'm killing Jon Hein.
Wow. See? Why?
What'd I do to you? Didn't even hesitate, Robin.
I love Ronnie. I've known Ronnie longer. And I would miss Ronnie more than John.
Here's Jason with a report. What is your report, Jason?
So I just took a staff poll. Who would you let live, Ronnie or John, if you had to make the decision? And I'm almost tickled to report that John lost that poll 0-8. 8 people voted to save Ronnie. 0 people voted to save Jon Hein.
JD, do you feel any better now that all these other people voted for Ronnie? Or are you still feeling guilty about killing Jon Hein?
No, I don't feel any better.
See, JD, all you had to do was pick up a phone and just say, hey, man, how you doing? This never
would have come up. Yeah,
that's true. John, will you accept a call from JD after the show where he backpedals?
No, I will not.
Oh.
Nor do I expect him to call, by the way.
I will not deny that Ronnie and Jon Hein are better friends to me than I am to them.
Do you think you're going to do something about it?
I would like to, you know, apparently they don't want to hear from me now, so I don't know how to go about that.